Carolina State Wolfpack come in as the number one ranked team, followed by Duke, Louisville, USC, and Syracuse. So, Clark, what's your initial impression of our top five teams?
I like the potential of each of these teams. I think all of them have a chance to win the championship this year. They're poised, loaded with talent, hungry, and very eager to prove themselves this coming year. I think each of these teams will be a dream to coach.
North Carolina State Wolfpack are projected as the favorites here in the early going. They were unstoppable last season, finishing with 26 wins.
Winning that many games again is going to be extremely difficult, no matter how much talent they have. Not many teams play that many games, never mind win that many. They'll be on the verge of dynasty status if they repeat that performance.
Duke is in the number two spot. They've got a whole crew of high school Mr. Basketballs on this team.
The team is usually happy to land one Mr. Basketball. With the number they have, this could be a golden era of basketball success at this university. There's nothing but good times ahead.
Louisville comes in as number three. From a sheer talent standpoint, this team is right at the top of the charts.
Their roster is jam-packed with former high school All-Americans. They're like a traveling all-star team. It tells you a lot about the appeal of this university to the top high schoolers in the nation.
USC starts the year as the fourth-ranked team. They carry over three starters from last year, but it shouldn't be too much of a learning curve for this team.
Yeah, they got the core of that team coming back, and that's going to be huge to them. There won't be much of the feeling out process that so many other teams will have to work through early in the season.
Syracuse is the number five team. Their dreams of tournament glory last year were quickly dashed in a first-round loss.
This year they have the potential to do much better than last. Last season they spent a lot of their energy getting to March Madness, and were worn out once they got there. I'll bet they handled the journey to the tournament much better this time.
Here's the next group of teams in our preseason top 25. What do you think of this group, Mark?
We've seen plenty of future national champions come out of this group from the middle of the top 25. I'm not willing to say just yet whether that is going to happen again this year, but a few teams certainly have the potential.
The California Golden Bears, the number 18, have been a topic of discussion heading into the season. One bit of news for them, they have last season's leading rebounder coming back for another year.
With that low post presence already established, they'll have a little bit of swagger heading into the season. I look for them to be sharp right from the start.
The Xavier Musketeers, the number 17, have also generated a lot of interest. They're a tough team, but they're going to have a very hard time surviving that vicious conference they're in.
That'll work to their advantage, Greg, because they'll have been through so many battles by the time March rolls around, tournament pressure won't bother them at all.
Okay, Clark, let's take a look at the team to close out the preseason top 25 poll. How about this list?
This looks to me like the deepest preseason top 25 poll we've seen in years. I think there are teams even all the way back in this group that are legitimate national championship contenders.
The Wake Forest Demon Deacons, the number 17 team, probably deserve a closer look. They bring back four starters, and that should pay huge dividends for them this year.
I can't tell you what an advantage that is for them. There's so much turnover in the college game these days, and having four starters coming back is almost unfair, Greg.
The West Virginia Mountaineers, the number 21 team, are also worth keeping an eye on. They rolled to second place in their conference last year in the regular season.
As good as that sounds, I think it was a bit of a letdown for them. They wanted to come out on top, and they probably still have a sour taste in their mouth from not getting it done.
As usual, we have a lot of new coaching hires to tell you about as we start the season. Here are all the new coaches in college basketball this season. Quite a few interesting names on the list. The DePaul coach is one of the hires that drew a lot of media attention. The DePaul Blue Demons have a lot of fans that are delighted to have a coach of his ability, Clark.
Very few new coaches can walk through the door and flash that NCAA championship ring. That boosts this program's profile right away.
The South Carolina coach also made a move to a new school. That's generated some excitement on that campus. The South Carolina Gamecocks are a team looking to rebuild under their new leader.
He's yet to find his way to that final weekend, but he still has an impressive resume. His new school is certainly hoping he can add a Final Four run to his list of accomplishments.
We now have the part of the show where we break down the top players in the nation and show you our preseason All-American list. What you see before you is the cream of the crop in college hoops. What a list. The North Carolina State Wolfpack are pinning their hopes squarely on this young man's shoulders. Mark
Cole is the first player on the list for good reason. Feels like this guy's been playing college basketball forever. This will be his fourth year as a starter, but I still don't take him for granted. I think this will be his best season of all.
As for our next first team, Duke, is more than willing to go into battle with you, Clark.
Edelman is simply a spectacular player. He's a former high school Mr. Basketball out of. He was Michigan's Mr. Basketball in high school. He's a hero in his home state, and he had to let those fans down. He's taken his game to the next level and improved as the competition has gotten stiffer.
Next up is a player that's drawing comparisons to some of the all-time college greats, the Villanova Wildcats. Are fortunate to have him in their corner.
Right. He's one of my favorite players in the country. We always talk about the guys with great hands. Well, he's got great feet. I love those happy feet. There are a few players in the nation with better footwork than him. And that's what allows him to always be in the right position, whether it comes to rebounding or finding space for an open shot.
Let's move on to a player who's worked very hard to earn his spot on the list. The Duke Blue Devil can depend on a solid effort from him each and every night.
Janus is going to play a huge role in his team's success. He was a tremendous rebounder last season. He came away with an average of 5 rebounds a game. I expect him to hit the glass with even more passion this year. He is a rugged competitor.
And finally, we have another superb player to round out the first team. The Villanova Wildcats will probably get used to seeing him make the impossible look ordinary.
Hoyer is going to have his own personal highlight reel by the end of this season. He's back for another go after leading his team in scoring a year ago. If he improves his offense even a little bit, he'll be one of the deadliest scorers in the country.
Now let's move on to the second team All-Americans. Not such a bad list, huh? These elite players all have the potential to have historic seasons if the right pieces fall into place. The Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets have built their team around this young man's talent. I'd say that's a pretty good idea.
Walter was close to a spot on the first team, but there was too much competition this season. He made his conference all-freshman team last season. He's already proven to the nation and to himself that he belonged on this level. This season, it's no longer about proving he belongs, but proving he's among the best of the best.
The next player on the team is a sensational player in his own right. Duke is in for a great year if he lives up to his potential.
He's in the spotlight for all the right reasons. He can make things happen on the basketball court thanks to his unique ability to read and understand defenses, while most players are just trying to come up with their next move. He's 3 steps ahead of the game, and that's what separates the good players from the great.
We can all look forward to some very exciting highlights from this young man this year. The Villanova Wildcats are looking for a lot of production from him, and they probably won't be disappointed.
Bane is an extremely powerful weapon for his team. If I had to pick some frontrunners for the Player of the Year award, he would be right there on the list. I've seen him take over games even when he isn't scoring 30. There are some great scorers among these All-Americans, and he's one of them. But he does much more than score.
Our next All-American may have his eyes on the first team by the end of the season. USC has one of the most reliable go-to guys in the country in him.
Vignale is one of the great talents in the college game today. There's plenty to like about him as a player. He's got that deadly combination of smart and physical skills that makes him so difficult to defend. The coach's mentality and the body of a world-class athlete. Any questions as to why he's on the list?
And here we have the final player on our list of All-Americans. The Connecticut Huskies know who their fan favorite is going to be this year.
Catalina is ready to have a breakout season. It isn't out of the realm of possibility to say that he might even be a little bit underrated. I know it seems far-fetched to say that about a preseason All-American pick, but I'm not sure people realize just what a huge year he's in for.
All right, Clark, that should do it for us here in the studio. For myself and all of us here at 2K Sports, thanks for watching our season preview. Enjoy all the college hoops action to come, everyone.